His active and vigorous work transformed Kyiv into one of the most prestigious scientific centers in Europe. Moreover, this scholar's breakthrough invention had a major impact on the development of both Ukrainian and international medicine. He was the first scholar who discovered medication which can prolong one's lifespan. Joseph Stalin expected that using this elixir, he would be able to rule Soviet state for longer. However, the internationally acclaimed pathophysiologist untimely died and left the Soviet dictator hopeless. For this failure, Stalin took revenge on the closest colleagues of the Ukrainian medic. Academician Oleksandr Bohomolets was committed to his studies to the extreme, and people said about him. Science was his pride and his life was to serve people. According to various ratings, Oleksandr Bohomolets is among the list of the 100 most famous Ukrainians. His scientific and organizational contribution gives grounds to believe that this person was extraordinary and fully deserved to be included in the list. He was a far-sighted scholar for his time. His organizational and managerial skills were the key aspects for building the modern order in the organization of the system of Ukrainian science. According to his biographers, he was interested in every sphere of physiology and medicine. His greatest contribution in medicine is anti-reticular cytotoxic serum that accelerated the healing of wounds, which saved millions of lives during the German-Soviet war. After this period in history, this method was incorporated in Western medical practices. The scholar is famous for his origins from the Chernihiv branch of the Lithuanian-Ukrainian Bohomolets family. His parents were members of the nobility, but since childhood, Oleksandr was fascinated by populist ideas. His parents were incarcerated due to their revolutionary activities, and therefore the grandfather on the maternal side raised him. The beginning of his life reminds one of a ghastly adventure novel. He was born in the Lukyanivka prison hospital in Kyiv. He was carried to relatives of his parents in a laundry basket. His mother received the death penalty after 2 months, but the sentence was reversed to 10 years of servitude. The future academician Oleksandr was the second child, and for 6 or 7 years he saw neither his father nor his mother, because his father had also been sentenced to exile. Oleksandr was allowed to visit his mother only after 10 years, when his father received permission to visit his wife. By that time, doctors diagnosed her as terminally ill with tuberculosis. The famous Russian writer Lev Tolstoy helped him get legal permission to visit his wife in the distant Transbaikalia. Oleksandr received permissions every day, but these meetings were fatal for Oleksandr. His mother died in a matter of several days, and he himself was infected with tubercle bacillus. Later, this would play a fatal role in his relatively short life. The physiological factor of the situation had a major impact on him. Just imagine that he was taken to Transbaikalia, which didn't have a developed railroad system and connections, to see his mother after 10 years. It was a shock. Once again, the road there was hard. Then he and his father buried the mother. He returned home. What child would experience such hardships without consequences? I believe he fought such stress by studying. He and his father faced a series of misadventures after his mother's death. At first, they lived in Nizhyn, where the boy attended a male gymnasium for a year. Then they moved to Chisinau, where his father's brother lived. Oleksandr continued to study in a local gymnasium, but right before graduation he was expelled because of his seemingly dangerous and threatening ideas.
демонстрував очевидно.
Arguably, he demonstrated the same rebellious character that he inherited from his parents. At the same time, those who knew him noted that he was exceptionally hardworking and had a strong craving for reading. The young man did not choose his profession right away. He enrolled at the Kyiv University Law Faculty in 1900, dreaming to become a criminal attorney. However, he re-entered to the medical faculty shortly after that. Nevertheless, he received the reputation of an unreliable person, since he participated in a student movement for their rights. Oleksandr transferred to the Odessa University for the sake of his career and the well-being of his father, who was under the constant surveillance of the local police authorities. He then moved to Odessa, and there he finished his studies with honors. Eventually, he got to the local academic chair, and in 1909, he completed his doctoral dissertation at the age of 28. His opponent was the internationally acclaimed Nobel Prize laureate and academician Ivan Pavlov. Academician Ivan Pavlov was surprised by the boldness and innovation of the young Ukrainian scholar. In Pavlov's opinion, he opened new horizons in the sphere of medical sciences in Ukraine. Oleksandr Bohomolets' doctoral thesis was the foundation for his further career growth. He received an internship placement at the Sorbonne Physiology Faculty in Paris. Then he became a professor of the medical faculty of the Saratov University upon his return. He returned in 1911, and he was assigned to the Nikolaevsk University in Saratov at the time, where he started his successful career and work. That was 14 years of his work, and it was the peak of his activities as a scholar. Oleksandr Bohomolets built the foundation of pathological physiology in Saratov. It was a totally new branch in modern medicine. He created the corresponding academic chair. What is pathology? It is a study about a disease. How do they form and progress? What is the proper approach to their treatment or even avoiding them? He is the first scholar who worked in this specialized sphere. He wrote 5 volumes of academic research that eventually became classics in the sphere of physiological pathology. Oleksandr Bohomolets positively received the news about the October Revolution in 1917. He was highly critical and negative about the reign of the Tsar due to his mother's death. During the civil war in Russia, he actively helped the Red Army to endure the epidemics of cholera, typhus, and malaria. Simultaneously, the scholar had his major invention in Saratov, as he created an immune serum that healed the wounds and activated the human immune system. Bohomolets' serum was successfully implemented for treating complex infections and fractures during the German-Soviet War. The high reputation of the young and potential scholar was heard in Moscow. He was assigned as the head of the pathology faculty at the Second Moscow University in 1925. It was exactly in this institution that he participated in creating the world's first institute of hematology and blood transfusion. He made a great contribution to the creation of the Institute of Hematology and had an innovative approach to blood conservation and blood transfusion. There is a specific procedure that enables a blood donor to avoid the clotting process. He made some suggestions, and later it became evident that blood should be transfused not only when the human body lacks it, but also for the purpose of stimulation. Oleksandr Bohomolets was accepted as president of the National Academy of Sciences of Ukraine. He arrived in Kyiv and managed the entire reorganization of its structure. He created the Institute of Experimental Biology and Pathology in the Institute of Physiology. The differentiated faculties and laboratories were united into scientific research institutions. Young and promising scholars were invited to work there. The structure of the National Academy of Sciences of Ukraine, created by Oleksandr Bohomolets, is preserved in general terms to this very day. He had to lead the Academy of Sciences of the Ukrainian SSR in the period of Stalin repressions. Moreover, he was on the verge of death several times.
Його рідня, двоюрідний брат Вадим Богомолець, який
His relative, cousin Vadim Bohomolets, developed the first project of the Ukrainian fleet under the reign of Hetman Pavlo Skoropadsky. His relatives fought on the side of the White Army. In particular, one of his family members was leading the battalion under Ataman Semyonov in Siberia. Moreover, his trips abroad and connections with the scholar and the cultural community were sufficient to enable Stalin to give an order that he be incarcerated. Despite this, it never happened. Regardless of the situation, Oleksandr Bohomolets did everything to save Ukrainian scholars who were under the suspicion of the Stalin regime.
Завдяки зусиллям Олександра Олександровича Богомольця залишились на волі.
Oleksandr Bohomolets' efforts enabled many people to avoid incarceration and probably the death penalty. Among them was the founder of the Ukrainian mathematician school Mykola Krylov. Bohomolets saved Alexander Lipunsky, who later became the pioneer of the fast nuclear reactor based on neutrons.
Він став батьком ядерного реактора на швидких нейтронах.
Besides that, Yevhen Paton was saved and freed from his death sentence after being arrested. Despite this, his contribution to the preservation of national science and saving of people's lives was never fully appreciated.
Порятунок просто людей, людей науки, він ще до кінця не оцінений.
Oleksandr Bohomolets administrated the work of 54 blood transfusion stations that worked according to his technology during World War II. He conducted the full reorganization of Ukrainian science for the needs during wartime. Oleksandr Bohomolets also founded a clinic for the treatment of premature aging in Kyiv, and shortly before the German-Soviet war, the Institute of Gerontology was created on its basis.
Він пізніше розробив перший в Радянському Союзі Інститут геронтології, який досліджував питання.
He was the first one in the Soviet Union to organize the Institute of Gerontology that researched the subject of human aging and its prevention.
Він опублікував такі статті про продовження життя.
Just like the scholar Ilya Mechnikov, he believed that a human could live 120 to 150 years.
Невеликим тиражем, ну, фактично на такому не дуже якісному папері.
Dr. Bohomolets' scientific research about premature aging and prolongation of human life became an international sensation. The U.S. Department of Defense announced a tender for the article about the best invention of that time in 1945. Everyone expected that it would be related to the topic of the atomic bomb. Millions of readers were surprised when the newspapers printed the report about anti-reticular cytotoxic serum, which made the prolonging of human life possible. The article had the title, "You Can Live Longer Tomorrow." For instance, the methods to prolong life were published as well. They announced that these discoveries belonged to the Ukrainian scholar Oleksandr Bohomolets. Bohomolets argued that people should not experience aging at 60 to 70 years. Such a statement was dangerous rebuke towards the current Soviet regime at the time. One can find blame in these words, so to say, that there were problems in the land of working people and the so-called proletarian heaven. Nonetheless, Stalin had no choice but to tolerate this rhetoric on the part of the doctor.
Найбільше він турбувався про збереження.
Stalin worried about the well-being and time span of his life first and foremost.
В такій ситуації він
notably in such a situation he was following the successes achieved in the sphere of medicine. Obviously, there was some kind of mystery in this sphere.
Своїми медичними дослідами лікар Богомолець давав.
Bohomolets gave him the hopes with his medical experiments. Stalin expected from him the elixir for prolonging life. It is said that after Bohomolets' death, Stalin was shocked, and some say that he said, "Can you imagine? He fooled everyone."
Причому сказав таку фразу: "Ти дивись, усіх обдурив."
Academician Bohomolets died suddenly in the summer of 1946. The tuberculosis infection and constant stress and lifestyle had a negative impact on his death. Stalin was furious with having no results in the area of longevity and took revenge on Oleksandr Bohomolets' relatives and colleagues.
Йому ставилося Богомольцю.
Bohomolets was blamed for being a proponent of an idealist philosophy, the Weissmannian theory, Morganism, and his false theory about consecutive tissues. He was also accused of sabotage of Pavlov's theory.
Про те, що він підриває вчення Івана Петровича Павлова.
The reputation of academician Oleksandr Bohomolets and the institutions he founded were reinstated after Stalin's death. The internationally acclaimed scholar loved people and life, unlike the tyrannical leader of the Soviet Union. He endured the egoistic dreams of the tyrant and remains immortal in people's memories.